Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, we are going to cover the current affairs of 8th December. First question is, which Indian armed force has recently conducted exercise Clean Sea 2018 at Sea of Port Blair? Right answer is Indian Coast Guard. Indian Coast Guard has conducted exercise Clean Sea 2018 at Sea of Port Blair. If we talk about Port Blair, it is the capital of Andaman and Nicobar. Andaman and Nicobar Command is the India's only tri-service command. If we talk about few other important exercises, MILEX is the joint military exercise of BIMSTEC countries. The headquarters of BIMSTEC is in Dhaka in Bangladesh, and the recent summit of BIMSTEC held in Kathmandu. After that, the members adopted Kathmandu Declaration. The next summit will be in Sri Lanka. Vostok is a military exercise of Russia. It is the largest military exercise since Cold War. Rapid Trident is an exercise conducted by Ukraine with the help of NATO members. The president of Ukraine is Mr. Petro Poroshenko, and Ukraine was in news as the president has imposed martial law for 30 days in Ukraine. The headquarters of NATO is in Brussels. Brussels is the capital of Belgium. Malabar is a trilateral exercise between India, USA and Japan. And Yudh Abhyas is a bilateral exercise between India and USA. Surya Kiran is a exercise between India and Nepal. And Maitri is a exercise between India and Thailand. Nomadic Elephant is a exercise between India and Mongolia. IBSA MAR is a exercise between India, Brazil and South Africa. The President of South Africa, Mr. Cyril Ramaphosa, will be the chief guest of 2019 Republic Day ceremony. IBSAMAR is a maritime exercise. Sahyog HOP TAC is a exercise between India and Vietnam, and Lamite is a exercise between India and Seychelles. Tharamgazian is a exercise between India and Japan. Sinu Maitri is also a exercise between India and Japan. It should be kept in mind, Sinu Maitri is an Air Force exercise between India and Japan, while Dharamgazian is an Army exercise between India and Japan, and Malabar is a Navy exercise between India, USA and Japan. Next question is, IDEATE for India is a joint collaboration between National E-Governance Division and which technological giant? Right answer is Intel. The Union Minister, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, has launched National Challenge for Youth, IDEATE for India, Creative Solutions Using Technology. This was launched in New Delhi. It will provide a platform to the school students to be a solution creator for the problems. It is open to students of class 6th to class 12 across the country. That means the students from all 29 states and 7 union territories can participate into this. This is a collaborative initiative of National E-Governance Division along with Intel India with the support of Department of School Education and Literacy of Human Resource Development. So there are three organizations: National E-Governance Division, Intel India and Department of Ministry of Human Resource Development. Next question is, who among the following have won the IAAF Athletes of Year Award recently? Right answer is B and C, that means Eliud Kipchoge and Catherine Abaguan. These two has won IAAF Athletes of Year Award. Mr. Eliud Kipchoge is from Kenya and he is a distance runner. The capital of Kenya is Nairobi, and Mr. Eliud Kipchoge has won this award in male category, while Miss Catherine Abaguan has won this award from female category. She is a triple jumper and she is from Colombia. The capital of Colombia is Bogota. Colombia is a South American country, while Kenya is an African country. If we talk about IAAF, it is International Association of Athletics Federation. It was formed in 1912. The headquarters of IAAF is in Monaco. If we talk about Monaco, it is a European country in the neighborhood of France. And Monaco City is the capital of this country. You might have heard the name of Monte Carlo, a popular brand. Monte Carlo is a name of city in Monaco. Next question is, which former Indian diplomat has been elected to an India-Pacific seat on United Nations Committee on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights? Right answer is Priti Saran. Ms. Priti Saran has been elected to an Asia-Pacific seat on United Nations Committee on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights. Her tenure will start from 1st of January 2019 and it will expire on 31st December 2022. If we talk about CESCR, that means Committee on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, it is a United Nations body of 18 experts that usually meets twice a year in Geneva to consider the 5 yearly reports. It considers the compliance of member countries on international covenant on economic, social and cultural rights. The members are elected for a term of 4 years and members serve in personal capacity. That means they do not represent that particular country, even though they are nominated by that country, and members can be re-elected. So there are 4-5 things. First thing first, it is a committee of United Nations. Second, it usually meets twice a year. Third, the meeting is in Geneva. Fourth, it considers a 5-yearly report. Fifth, the report is about International Covenant on Economic, Social and Cultural Rights. Covenant means agreement. Next question is, which state government has launched Smart Initiative for Agribusiness and Rural Transformation? Right answer is Maharashtra. The Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Mr. Devendra Fadnavis, has launched a unique initiative called SMART for the Agribusiness and Rural Transformation. The SMART stands for State of Maharashtra Agribusiness and Rural Transformation. It is a World Bank assisted project to revamp or to transform the agricultural value chains with a special focus on marginal farmers. If we talk about World Bank, it was formed in 1945 and the headquarters is in Washington DC. Mr. Jim Yong Kim is the president of World Bank. Answer in comment box, which state government has recently started PETA initiative to spread the awareness regarding government initiatives? Next question is, what is India's position in terms of CO2 emitter in 2017 as per the recent study by Global Carbon Project? Right answer is fourth. There was a study by Global Carbon Project and as per that study, India is the fourth largest emitter of CO2. The top four emitters in 2017 are China, USA, European Union and India. It should be kept in mind that if we consider only countries, then India is on third position. However, European Union is considered as a bloc, so India is on fourth position. China emitted 27% of CO2, while USA emitted 15%, European Union emitted 10% and India emitted 7% of CO2. The top 10 emitters are China, USA, EU, India, Russia, Japan, Germany, Iran, Saudi Arabia and South Korea. As per the study, India and China still rely heavily on coal. The study was recently released on the occasion of 2018 United Nations Climate Summit in Katowice, COP24, that means Conference of Parties, held in Katowice in Poland. The capital of Poland is Warsaw and Poland is a European country. Next question is, what is the theme of 2018 World Soil Day? Right answer is, be the solution to soil pollution. Every year on 5th of December, World Soil Day is observed to spread the awareness regarding soil. The theme of this year is, be the solution to soil pollution. If we talk about important days of December month, 1st December is World AIDS Day. The theme of World AIDS Day was Know Your Status. 1st December is also the formation day of Nagaland. Nagaland was formed on 1st December 1963. 2nd December is National Pollution Control Day, while the Population Control Day is observed on 11th July. So Pollution Control Day is on 2nd December and Population Control Day is on 11th July. Apart from that, 2nd December is also World Computer Literacy Day and International Day for Abolition of Slavery. Answer in comment box, which country has become the first country in world to recognize orphanage trafficking as modern day slavery? 3rd December is International Day of Persons with Disabilities. 4th November is Indian Navy Day. 5th November is World Soils Day. 6th November is Mahaparinirvan Divas. It is the death anniversary of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. 7th December is Indian Armed Forces Flag Day and International Civil Aviation Day. Next question is, who has been appointed as new Chief Economic Advisor? Right answer is Mr. Krishnamurthy Subramaniam. Mr. Subramaniam has been appointed as new Chief Economic Advisor. Earlier Chief Economic Advisor was Mr. Arvind Subramaniam. Recently, his book was in news. His book is Off Council, The Challenges of Modi-Jetli Economy. If we talk about few other important appointments, Mr. Sunil Arora has been appointed as Chief Election Commissioner, while Mr. Arvind Saxena has been appointed as UPSC Chairman. Mr. Nageshwar Rao Guntur has been appointed as Chairperson of Atomic Energy Regulatory Board, and Mr. Jalal Srivastava has been appointed as Chairman of Inland Waterways Authority of India. Lieutenant General Rajeshwar has been appointed as 12th Chief of Integrated Defence Staff. Mr. Ajay Bhushan Pandey has been appointed as Revenue Secretary, and Mr. Narayan Jha has been appointed as Finance Secretary. Answer in comment box, who is the present Cabinet Secretary? Mr. Ashok Kumar Gupta has been appointed as Chairperson of Competition Commission of India, and Mr. Sekhar Mande has been appointed as Director General of CSIR. Next question is, Maulana Asrar-ul-Haque Kazmi, who passed away recently, was the Lok Sabha MP from which constituency of Bihar? Right answer is Kishanganj. He was from Kishanganj constituency. If we talk about few other politicians who passed away recently, the former president of USA, George H.W. Bush, passed away. His full name was George Herbert Walker Bush. He was the 41st president of USA. Mr. Anant Kumar, who was the former Union Minister for Parliamentary Affairs, passed away. Mr. C.K. Jafar Sharif, who was former Railway Minister, also passed away. Mr. N.D. Tiwari, who was the former Chief Minister of UP, passed away. He also served as the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand. Mr. Madan Lal Khurana, who was the former Chief Minister of Delhi, passed away. Mr. Tran Dai Quang, who was the former President of Vietnam, also passed away recently. Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who was former Indian Prime Minister, and Mr. Balaramji Das Tandon, who was former Chhattisgarh Governor, also passed away. Mr. Somnath Chatterjee, who was former Lok Sabha Speaker, passed away recently. Answer in comment box, who was the first Speaker of Lok Sabha? Mr. M. Karunanidhi, who was the former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, also passed away recently. Next question is, which short story writer has bagged 2018 Sahitya Academy Award for Kashmiri language? Right answer is Mustaq Ahmed Tantre. Mr. Mustaq Ahmed has been given Sahitya Academy Award for Kashmiri language. If we talk about Sahitya Academy Award, it is award given for individual contribution to literature. It is given for the work published in 24 languages. That means 22 languages which are mentioned in 8th schedule of constitution, plus the work published in English and Rajasthani. So there are total 24 languages. The award was first awarded in 1954. Thank you, and that's all for the day.